Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Kari Lanza from Helsinki, Finland, from Port Scandinavia. And I can tell you that what happened today here in Thessaloniki, if this would happen in Scandinavia, we still stand in front of the city hall, freezing and thinking what to do next. How did you move the whole conference with 300 people in 2 hours from building to other? It was amazing. I will remember this the rest of my life. So, Finland is up there. We are long country with very few people, lot of forest and lakes. And we were known before country by Nokia, but as you know that Nokia is falling down, we are not very proud anymore about this Nokia brand, but today we are country of anchors. Did you know that anchors come from Finland? We are country of anchors today. Okay, let's go to the library again. This is the main post office in the very center of Helsinki, and library again has been now 7 years there. We are open every day, 80 hours per week. We have between 2,000 and 2,500 customers weekdays, a little bit less weekends, and we have 800 square meters space for our services. And just other side of the street, we have like a small branch of library 10, we call it Meeting Point. And Meeting Point is a special library, we don't have any books at Meeting Point. We have different guidance services, working facilities, and a lot of cooperation with the public and private sector. This was library 10 a couple years ago. This is library 10 now. So you can see the difference. We started to rethink how we use library space. And first thing what we get is that we must make library much, much more visible than it was before. That when you come in the library, you open the door, you see everything what is going on in the library. No bookshelves, no desk, nothing barricades or labyrinths here, but everything will be open. Our opening hours are there, you can see weekdays we are open till 10 o'clock and Friday, Saturday, Sunday till 8 o'clock. And we make also ourselves more visible. It wasn't easy work to get stuff to use for quests. We discussed about 200 hours about that. Some of our staff members, they told immediately that they will lose identity if they use those working quests. But today, after these 100 hours, all our staff members, they use those quests. Because we walk around the library all the time, so our customers, they have to see who is staff member and who is not. Here's our group. I'm a senior. Our average age is under 35 years, and about 80% of our staff members are male or boys. And the reason for this is that in Finland, when boys are 18 years old, they have to decide if they go to military service or unmilitary service. And we have all the time two or three boys in unmilitary service, in library 10. And after that unmilitary service, they can start to study to be as a library assistant, same time when they are working. So we grow up all the time, new generation of male librarians in library 10. Most of our male librarians have been before our non-military service boys. And we made also our customers more visible. Before we had chairs and tables between bookshelves, those were quite high, but now we move it to that kind that everywhere where you sit, you always see other people. We thought that people are more interested for other people than just book and see themselves. And our customers, they are not also very typical lifestyle customers. Most of them are between 50 and 30 years. Before we had about 60% of customers were male. Today about 50%. But very big customer group is young men. So we have a situation that we have a lot of young men working in library and a lot of young men as a customer in our library. This picture is from lunch break disco. We organized during lunch break 50 minutes disco in our library, and people from different offices, they come after lunch to dance with it. They go back to work. This is a real question. One day, one of our customers, regular customer, he stopped me and asked that why in all libraries chairs are so uncomfortable. And always when customers, when they ask some strange or stupid questions, we should stop and think why they ask this kind of questions. And the fact is that when we think about furnishing, we think about bookshelves. We don't think about our chairs and tables. And if we want that customers they stay, not only visit library, but they stay in library, we have to have comfortable furnishing. We have to have flexible furnishing. We have a lot of those small tables. People can move those from place to other. And it's important that the customers, they can furnish that library space as they need. They move chairs and tables all the time from place to other. They make this kind of working or studying or meeting environment what they want. And I can tell you that every evening library gym is totally different than in the morning. Because our users stay all the time furnished the library space themselves. And same time when we make those changes in library 10, we start to renovate also that meeting point. And we start to think that what is the new need, what our users need from library space. And we found that those people who make small business, freelancers, students who make some part-time work, that they don't have good working places anywhere. Mostly they work at home. And we started to develop urban office for those mostly young people who need kind of office space in the centrum of Helsinki. And we bought some mobile soundproof chairs so they can work in a peaceful like capsule. And we have also a lot of different old and new office supplies. So they can borrow hole punchers, staplers, tape, pens, adapters, cables, etc. They can also ask screens for their meeting. All kinds of possibilities they need, they can ask for free from our urban. And when they need a bigger meeting place, they can make reservations for walls. Before, and of course today, customers, they make mostly reservations for books. But in urban office, they make reservations for walls. And last spring, American Library Association, they called us, and they told that they have chosen urban office as the best foreign innovation of the year. And I asked them that why? It's just chairs and tables. They thought that because it's totally new way to use chairs and tables. So it doesn't mean that if you have to make innovation to make a lot of money, you can just rethink how you use those chairs and tables. And another new service we have for cooperation with companies is library. And idea of the library is that those companies, they can bring new innovations which are not ready yet to library, that our customers, they can test and they can borrow those and they can give feedback. So our customers make cooperation with companies in Finland to develop new innovations for our market. And this is very new in Finland and in Helsinki, that all the time we go deeper and deeper in cooperation with the private companies. And I think it's good way that it's benefit for both us. We don't have foreign newspapers anymore. All our newspapers are digital, and we don't have hardcover books at all. All our books are paperbacks, so we order that kind of material for people want from us. This is big change. This is going on right now, and it's going faster and faster. Library is not anymore place to use. Just news media. It's more and more place for create media, especially young people. They come to library to make own things. They come to make own videos. They come to make own music. They come to make own programs, own multimedia. So customers, they are more and more doers and creators today. And also, especially young people, they want to be there. They want to be here. They want to be performers. They want to make own performance all time, and they want to make own events. And this was even for us a big surprise when we calculated all events we had last year, 150 something, 80% of those were organized by our customers. 5 years ago, we organized everything by ourselves. And last 5 years, we have tried to give this message for our customers that public library is public space, it's your place, you can come and organize own events, you can organize own festivals, own panel discussions, and now start to work. Now they come, they organize, and we can help them. They are producers, small children, they can make own CDs with singing chair. It works like karaoke, they sing those favorite songs, and then we record those for CDs, and they can give us a Christmas present for relatives, those. We have DJ librarians working in evening time. We have a vinyl bar where people can digitize all the vinyl LPs and all C cassettes. And this is change which is going on right now. That library is not anymore just reading rooms, more and more working rooms. In Scandinavia, we have thought libraries as a living rooms few years. I don't like this word living room, because living room is quite passive room. In living room, you just sit down, watch TV, read magazines, everything active also always happens in kitchens. I like to see libraries more like kitchens than living rooms. That there is a lot of different chefs cooking different information and culture, and we never know what we get up from the kitchen in the end. And we are moving from bookstores to public space. We don't collect books anymore. If people don't read those books, we move those away. We want to develop our library more and more like a public space for many, many different activities. We also change the way how we ourselves, how we work. We are not anymore hiding behind desk, if somebody is coming, no, I hope not. But we try to walk and talk with our users, and it's also important that how you walk with the customers. When they come to ask information, do you walk front and they follow, or do you walk next to them, that you can speak same time with your customer when you walk around the library? Anything to worry, even the whole world will be more or less digital in the future. We, as a library, we still have service and content. Whatever will happen, libraries will be strong. And here is our new vision. Library is enricher for ideas and thoughts, whereby sharing knowledge, skills and stories, we together create a new civic society. And I especially like this first one, that whatever we do in future libraries, we do it together with our customers. Thank you.